Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. Okay, we died last episode, and I had to fight the will-o'-wisps over. Went a lot better this time. I found out that fan of flames is a freaking
yes,
awesome spell. Yes. Yeah. It damaged this will-o'-the-wisps, really. I mean, they must have been half dead altogether. So, unfortunately, Aloth still.
How may I help?
Is that his name, Aloth? I can't remember the names, Aloth. Or maybe I can. He was still knocked out, but with Theodess and the aid of her Gon's Pledge, which we used twice, she was able to use a couple spells and her sword to bring down the foe. And this time, we didn't have to use up any of her potions. And I found a potion hidden away for Aloth.
Indeed.
Unfortunately, it's a regen potion. So gonna have to use it before he is past the point of no return, if we're gonna use it. So we camped again, and yeah, everything happened pretty much the same. We had that same dream and everything. So, and I know I messed up at some point by having the wrong character. I thought I was on another character, but see, I want them both to start. Oh. Have them both start with arrows. Now we're going to switch back. Well, I'll have her use the spell Soul Shock on him. So he's going to be the anchor for that spell. Damage them. And I don't know, they're still running, so I think he might miss them with this arcane assault. But I can cast it anywhere, right? So how about right here?
How may I help?
By doing that. Oh my god, see that? That's how quick. Yeah, he's out of the count. Just unfortunate. Already activated. Well, I don't think we can use it now, can we? Can I use something else? Okay, well, this one's near death. Did she use it yet? Oh god, please use it. Okay. Is it dead? Can you hit it? Can you hit the thing? It's still alive? Have you hit it yet? Can we, like, leave or something? I don't see how we're gonna survive this. Is she dead now? Now, what's up with this one? Near death. So it's... Is it unconscious? She's hit it a few times, right? I mean, I can't really see what she's doing. But... Hit it, right? Chop. She's dead. Alright, not sure here. What to do?
Sure.
Is this dungeon too tough for us? I mean, where should we be leveling up? I mean, this is basically... It's not far in the game here. Takes a while to cast these spells, so let's do the soul shock. Maybe by the time they get over here. And if he can just use Fan of Flames before he passes unconscious,
yes,
that'd be great. He misses. Okay. Fan of Flames, please. No, please use the sword. Just cast it. Hurry up. Good. One's down. He's already dead. See how quickly that happens? It's crazy. That I had time to charm this thing. I really just want to destroy them. Oh my god.
Oh, I don't feel so good.
No kidding. Okay, I don't think we can be fighting these yet. I'm trying, guys. We don't have much of a time to do anything. So... Let's not go in there. I wish I could mark the map somehow. I mean, that's really missing from this.
No problem.
Yeah, no problem. Let's not go in there. And how tough is this frickin' dungeon? I mean, maybe if we use regeneration. Maybe there's no big mama in here. Now, I don't think that wave that she cast on him, which is called, what do you call it? Soul shock. I don't think that worked. I don't think they were close enough yet. So maybe just have her stand here and do nothing, because... Her arrow goes off first, and then they run forward, and his arcane thingy doesn't hit from where they used to be. So...
Eh?
See, it's gonna miss now. I mean, I don't know if maybe you can draw those spiders away, but to where? Talking about the other ones. Hopefully they'll get close enough by then.
Hi.
He missed. Now he's messed up already. It's the poison. You can find some anti-venom somewhere. Take this, hon. And you... We need a tank type. Let's see if he'll outlast it because of that. Fan of Flames might just kill these freaking things. That's better.
Aye?
Aye. Please do this quickly. Okay. Now I want to look at this again. See, what we want to look for is the little plus sign, which is very hard to see for some stupid reason. There's none here. So why does she have experience 3,094 out of 3,000? Doesn't that mean she can level up? That she, you know, is now over the 3,000 mark? Saving here because who knows what's next in this room.
Nice and quiet.
Although it's probably... Oh! There's more! Hate these things. We really need to get a lot stronger. I have another party member. Maybe I should run back to the Black Wolf Inn? Black Hound. The Black Hound. And recruit that other party member. Strength in numbers and all that. So this is an ivory spiderling and that's an ivory spinner and these things are harder. What do you think? He doesn't have Fan of Flames this time. What does he have? Oh, he does. Is it per... Oh, really? Is it per combat? That puts a better grasp on things, then. Ten meters. Can we use that? Minor missiles.
Aye.
Not too bad. We have time for one more before he dies. By the time he casts it, they'll be caught up, right? And you? I'm using the wizard to tank. You realize that? He's an expendable asset.
Yeah.
Nice. I think we should use that tactic in the other room. Start off with the magic missile look-alike things.
Eh?
And go fan of flames and have her cast a spell on him.
Time to see and not be seen.
Any more? Or is this it? Apparently this is it inside the room, okay. This pile of furniture is branded with scorch marks. Whoever sat here left in a hurry. Ink has dripped across the scroll, obscuring its contents. I don't suppose this is trapped.
Quickly and quietly.
So walk past it, walk around. Nope, okay. A turquoise. Turquoise is an amorphous semi-precious stone, opaque and blue or blue-green in its general color, but often flecked with larger deposits. And I forgot to start my timer. I'm guessing we're 15 minutes in, supposedly. And a letter home. I actually sell this for 13 copper. Well, you know, minus commission, whatever that they get. Mother, I have asked Brother Edric to carry this letter to you, for he travels to New Hiamar come morning. With him goes what coin I have, and I hope it will ease the surprise of an unexpected homecoming, for I mean to follow in a few days' time. Our village is much changed, and though I do not wish for you to worry, I do not feel it is safe to remain. I know Rectrix Obrica will not approve, but... The letter trails off here. And again, these lone semi-quotes. Okay, that's it. Can't get anything from these spiders. Okay, so this is our map. So we have to fight those things. Are we gonna camp again? Because he's really damaged. Oh, wait. It's in this portrait, right? Not the character. Not that portrait. I'll remember this at some point. This is why how she levels up. Okay, good. So we have 7 points we could put in here. Yeah, I think we need that. Athletics, survival. Okay. Put athletic and survival up. Use level 1 scrolls. So now she can use level... Okay, and if we blew that, she can use level 2 scrolls. Or stealth. Take another athletics. Hopefully it'll help her not die so quickly. Ooh, we've got level 2 powers now. Amplified thrust. Let's see what this stuff does. Bounces psychic energy harmlessly off the target and onto the closest nearby enemy, causing pierce damage and violently pushing them backward. Oh, okay. So this is another one I can cast on my fellow party member. Really? Does a good amount of pierce damage. Well, this will help with those spiders. Mental binding overwhelms the target's mental ability to communicate with its own body, paralyzing it and causing its soul to emit a shockwave that can leave nearby enemies stuck. Cool. Paralyzed for 8.1 seconds. Versus will, of course. Okay. So it's basically harmless. You just sticks them. Mind blades. Co-opts the target's essence, generating a slashing blade of force that attacks them before leaping up to 5 additional targets. Okay, good for multiple foes. Because it does... It does slashing damage there, and then jumps. Plus 5 jump targets. Ooh! That's great for damaging a lot of foes at once. Awesome. I can choose 2 of these. Phantom foes. Invades the minds of targets in the area of effect, causing them to believe they're surrounded by phantom foes, leaving them flanked for the duration. Do they try to attack these phantom foes? Or is it just a flanking effect? And they'll go after us anyway. I don't know. Psycho Vampiric Shield. I like that. The cipher uses the target's strength of mind against it, stealing a portion of its resolve in order to better deflect incoming attacks. Okay, it drains into yourself. That's a cool. That's a buff, obviously, and a debuff and buff. Recall Agony. Causes a target to relive the psychic trauma of an injury moments after receiving it, experiencing the damage all over again. Okay, so first they need to get damage, and then we can cast it. So what I like this one, definitely. And what else? Right now we're just becoming established, you know, as fighters. I think right now what we really want is something that damages really quickly. I don't know how effective these spells are, you know. I don't know about this spell. That's a buff. That's good after. Oh, you know what? I'll take these 2 for now. No new talents. Ta-da! Now I wish... Two per rest. You know what I think? Outside of combat, it's 2 per rest, and in combat, it's 2 per, you know.
No problem.
What do you call it?
No problem.
Per no problem.
I'll see what I can find.
Per encounter. Because I've had her use that almost every fight. I just wish she wasn't so low. Well, he still has 40 out of 40.
Aye?
Endurance, he has 40. So this is his. The way they have it work, his endurance is per combat, and his health, if I have it right, his health is his overall health. So he's not that well off. I hate to keep camping though, I really do.
Indeed.
Eh?
Indeed, but we need. These things are strong. I mean, maybe we could do it now that we have that technique. Let's not leave anything to chance here. Okay. We're good. there's another chamber back there, isn't there? Doesn't it look like it? From... wait a second. Yeah. I can see it. Can I just...
what?
Oh. Theodos has discovered something.
My eyes are peeled.
What'd you discover? Oh, that. Let's see what's in here then. Maybe there's no monsters. Maybe it's just a choke. Well, no. There's monsters. Skuldr whelp. Now, if this thing can ever, like... oh, he doesn't have sight.
How may I help?
Oh, it ran off.
Got it.
Where you going, little guy? Stop yelling. Is it coming back? I don't like all these open areas. There it is. Does he have sight now? Yes.
I?
Oh boy, there's two of them. And he missed, of course. Cast that on him. Oh, wow. Well, that wasn't bad at all. Now we still got this area behind us, and I don't like that, so.
I'll see what I can find.
So we'll do that.
Yes.
So he can use that. Okay. I'm used to Dungeons and Dragons games where you can
indeed.
only use the spell once a day. Mm-hmm. Both of us, please. Come on. Vermin have scoured these plates, though mold still grows in green-black clumps across the table. Beautiful. Can't see it. These collapsed stones are pocked with burrows and narrow crevices. Claw marks and dung mark the passage of beasts. Stinky beasts. Oh, he can level up. Still got those spiders back there. Here you go, my friend. So you could definitely use some athletics. possibly some survival. Really good with lore. It's a pretty cool portrait. Almost looking like a painting, his face, though. Stealth. Mechanics. Athletics. Ooh, we got new spells, level 2. Bewildering Spectacle. We only can choose two of these. creates a bizarre and perplexing visual distraction, confusing enemies in the area of effect. Okay, so basic confusion spell. How long duration? Range. 6.5 seconds, base 5. Okay. Blinding web. Spins a resilient, viscous web throughout the area of effect, reducing movement for all affected. Okay, hobbled. Bulwark against the elements. Creates a mystical shield around the caster, suffusing them with bonuses to burn, freeze, corrode, and shock damage reductions. Definitely could have used that with the will-o'-wisp thing, which shocks you. Burn, freeze, corrode. Now, I wonder if that could help with the spiders, because they're in some kind of ice thing? I don't know. Combusting wounds. Causes enemy wounds in the area of effect to ignite, inflicting additional burn damage over time each time they are wounded. Oh, we have all these. I'm gonna read all these and that'll be the end of the episode, so up to you guys if you want to tune out. Console Heart's Corrosive Siphon. Eats away at the target's spirit, inflicting corrosive damage and converting that essence into endurance for the caster. I like that. Very short range, though. And it's over time. I do like that, though. That'll help him. Curse of Blackened Sight. Shrouds the target's vision in total darkness, blinding them. It's a blindness spell. Fetid Caress. The target becomes paralyzed, afflicted with boiling pustules of foul-smelling liquid that erupt from their skin, sickening those nearby. Oh, man. Paralyzed, sickened. That's cool. Infuse with Vital Essence. Infuses the caster with vitality, giving them a temporary increase in current and maximum endurance. Mm. I think you can use that. It's a fast one, too. Yeah. I'm going to use that. So let's keep that. Merciless Gaze. The caster becomes able to see an enemy's weaknesses and vulnerabilities as though they were physically tangible, increasing the chance of landing a critical hit. Okay, so first cast this and then wail on the enemy, basically. Miasma of Dull-Mindedness. A cloud of heavy fog settles in the minds of those in area of effect, dulling senses and wits, inflicts penalties to perception, intellect, and resolve. For how long? For the entire combat? It doesn't have a duration. Mirrored Image. Creates duplicates of the caster to distract enemies, granting a high deflection bonus, which is reduced with each hit taken. Necrotic Lance. Creates a lance of pure necrotic energy, causing corrode damage instantly and over time. Ooh, that one's pretty nice. 37 to 48 corrode. Over 6.5 seconds. That one's pretty cool. Ray of Fire. Creates a scorching ray of flame between the caster and the target, inflicting continual burn damage to the target and anyone caught in the ray. Duration 10 seconds. Now that can become complicated. If we need to step in front of him, or between him and the target, or what if the target moves over to another party member and the ray moves. Yeah, that's friendly fire problem there. So I'm going to wait for that. Besides, we got another fire spell that's pretty freaking awesome. What if we find things that, you know, fire doesn't affect that much? So, creates a rebounding ball of fire, rolling flame, inflicting burn damage upon anyone in its path. That one's pretty cool, too. I just don't want to have just fire spells, though, because if we find something that's resistant to fire, it's not going to work that well. So, I like necrotic lands, because that's corrode damage. I don't know what can be resistance against corrosion. Everything corrodes after time. Everything and everyone. So, infused with vital essence, that's basically his healing spell, and necrotic lance. No new talents. Okay. That's it. That's it for now. I actually want to go back and fight those spiders before I continue on. I feel like we can take them now, you know, if we're smart about it. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.